I'm going to start my conversation with a story. You see an image here. A baby elephant is tied to a hard metal chain, whereas the mother is tied to a very thin rope. The baby elephant is constantly trying to unchain itself, and it's failing. And as and when it grows, it is conditioned that it can't even break free the tiny thin rope. So today, I'm talking about guesses, potential, ability. So this story basically denotes potential or ability. When someone is trying to unlock their potential, then that's called success. The guilt of not exploring our potential is called failure. I'm here today to share my experiences and a few learnings of success and failure, which I've experienced in my life. And before that, let me tell you who I am. Born on August 25th, 1987, I'm a South Bangalorean. I love idli vada. I love coffee. I love South Bangalore. I was born to Vasudev Joshi and B.S. Annapurna. That's my mother. They both came from a very, very ordinary middle class background. And they struggled really, really hard to build their lives. I'm very proud about them. My father loved my mother and vice versa. And in between them, I was born. So they loved me too. We were a loving family. And my dad was persistently trying to keep us happy and better. I think he wanted to be an actor, so he saw his dreams through me. At the age of 7, I got a break in this film called Nammura Mandaru Huve. That's my stepping stone into cinema. Where the film goes out to be a blockbuster, I get a lot of fame, awards and rewards. I was popular. I never expected this. It was by my dad's effort. I want to repeat it. Followed by that, my film career elevated. More and more hits were added to my list. I had an awesome life. My dad protected me against all the odds and made sure I was right there on the top. I had a perfect childhood and an awesome teenage. As I said, I was a protected child, and my dad had too much of love for me. So, you know, that's where he decides that he should give a little push, an elevation to my career. So when things are going fine, absolutely fine, that's where there's a twist in the story, right? I was no different. So, my dad decides to produce a film for me. I should always mention this because the last 10 years of his life was a little challenging. He met with an accident, so he was kind of like about half a feet short. He had a limping foot, and he also developed glaucoma, or diminishing blindness due to diabetes. Despite all this, he took up a challenge of making a film for his son, so that his future is going to be awesome. I think that was the time where he kind of fell off the wagon. Many investors pulled out. Completing the film itself was a very big deal. But somehow, with great efforts, every day, for like about 3.5 years, we finally managed to complete the film and release it successfully. But the film was not successful enough. The film bombed big time. We lost all our assets. Our debts grew. I started losing opportunities from all the other films as well. And the biggest of all disasters, I lost my father due to multiple organ failure. This was totally unexpected, and I never ever realized that I'm going to face a situation like this. All of a sudden, I was a fat 19-year-old failed hero aspirant weighing 123 kgs and who was desperate for success and lack of opportunities. It was very, very difficult for me. In the beginning, as I said, I didn't accept it. I cornered myself. I cried. I pitied myself. I was constantly looking for help from people around me. More or less, I became a liability to people around me. And not just that, you know, I was struggling to even meet my ends. It was not that easy. But this was all in 2007, 12 years ago. But now, it's totally different. I'm a changed person, things have changed, and I feel I'm better now. How? That's because I had a belief in this theory, which was constantly running around in my everyday life. And I want to call it as three-man theory. It's my own invention. I've coined this word. It's called three-man theory. It has three phases. To start with, I want to call it avamana or humiliation. Many great things in this world have started because of humiliation. People shame you. They put you in doubt. They challenge you. And there's so much of conflict inside. More than everything, there's so much of not being accepted in the society within you. It kind of haunts you. It doesn't let you be in peace. Somehow, it initiates you to take challenges and test your true potential. This is called avamana. Basically, if you ask me, the beginning of success is humiliation. Okay, followed by that is called anumana. That's the doubt. When you take up a challenge, you constantly try and fail, try and fail, try and fail on an everyday basis. Sometimes you want to give up, but you don't. But the one who is witnessing you has a doubt. Whether is he going to do it? I don't think so. But trust me, every single time when somebody doubts you, you are increasing your capability of surprising them and taking them towards your successful path. So I can call it a benefit of doubt to oneself, because when in doubt, it's always a no. But sometimes there are a few things that doesn't harm you if you continue to do it. So you can use it to your advantage, is all I'm trying to say. Followed by that is sanmana, the honor. Persistent effort, every day you keep doing it, in and out, in and out, in and out. And someday, because of the constant efforts, honest efforts, you reach your goal. And that is the day you walk with pride. There's a lot of honor that you get for the work that you have done, for the achievement. More than everything, a sense of rewarding oneself is called sanmana. Success can be to oneself and to the world. Success gives you a lot of money, fame, comfort, a lot of things that we crave for. And one can be successful without any of these as well. It's very subjective. But what I have realized about being successful is that there's a small trick to it. And the trick is, it's more of a hack. Success and failure are two faces of the same coin. They both coexist. Ask me how. With every failure, you build a desire to win. And with every success, you have a new failure attached to it. Actually, success and failure does not mean anything. I want to go one step further and say this. Success and failure as emotions do not mean anything. As the incident of nature, by nature, they do not have any value by itself. It is us who attach greater meanings to it. It is we who decide, oh, I'm successful, oh, I'm failure. It's because we know ourselves better than anybody. But there's a bit of success in failure and a bit of failure in success, like the famous yin yang, as we all know. They both go hand in hand. But talking about success and failure, when I was a fat 19-year-old kid who was insecure, lacking opportunities, and trying to be successful every day, I realized a few things. This was way back in 2007. Somehow, the sense of being rejected in the society constantly pushed me to go out and do something every day. In fact, I panicked so much and I did so many things, I didn't even realize what I was trying to do. But somehow, I was honest enough to do a lot of things. I went out to be an RJ. That was the first breakthrough. So, every day morning, I woke up the city from an outdoor broadcasting jock, or a basic RJing position in a radio station. I move on to be one of the highest heard RJs in the country, with almost 3.5 million listenership per week and over 6,000 hours of RJing. This is what I did. And we made Kannada radio popular and friendly, and I am really proud about it. And from there, I continue to act in films. I do a bit of theater, almost like about 20, 21 plays. I get the Best Director award. It motivates me to go further. And from there, I continue to act. I start getting more and more recognition as a popular entertainer. Later, I also hosted a few shows on TV, and I've done almost close to 1,500 live shows in more than, up to 21 countries, I can say, more than 21 countries. And not just that, I was also a popular contestant in the reality show Big Boss and Dancing Star 3. All this made me look really, really successful. But here is a small twist which changed my life. Once, when I was doing a show, sitting inside my studio, I was shoving food in my mouth. That's when I realized I was 123 kgs and I got to do something about it. I thought and thought about it. Finally, I decided I'll go running. First day was hell, trust me. I couldn't even do like about 100 meters. But over a period of time, I signed up myself for a 10-kilometer run. And my first 10-kilometer run was 96 minutes. But later, my personal best moved on to be 55 minutes. Yeah, thank you. With that, somehow I developed a love for long distance running. And I start running. I enjoyed it so much, I did not realize that I had run close to 5,000 kilometers in 4 years, covering up to almost 50 half and full marathons, including 3 ultra marathons and a few thousand kilometers of cycling. Most importantly, without even my knowledge, I had lost 42 kgs. And this was the turning point of my life, is what I want to say. So, I continued to do many things. Later, I joined Flipkart as their creative head for digital communications. My job started going behind the camera. I started becoming a technician. But somewhere, that love for my dad was haunting me. I wanted to do something for my dad. So I decided, I'll quit a full-time job. Let me get out of this comfort zone and put myself into test. So I start our production house. My dad's production house, which was shut shop after he passed away. After 12 years, I tried to bring it back into life. So how do I do it? So I wanted to get closer to people. I definitely didn't want to do a film. So I think of something which is unique, which is inspiring. That is Joshile, the web series. Through that, we almost collaborated with more than 120 artists. 28 real stories were followed for almost 6 years. And all the 28 of them were differently abled talents. Every single person, a man without hands, how can he swim? A man without legs, how can he run? This was kind of inspiring me, and I wanted to tell this to people. Finally, when we wanted to produce it, I had almost like about a dollar in my pocket because that's where I wanted to start it fresh. I made up my mind to run 500 kilometers over 50 days, and finally, we managed to pull in almost 60,000 USD, that is 42 lakhs worth content, absolutely free of cost on YouTube today. This was a huge achievement to an independent filmmaker like me because not many dared to do it. Yep. Okay. I did lot of things. As I said, I was consistently craving for success. I went on a marathon of doing things. I didn't expect any results. But is it just success that I encountered in this entire journey? Definitely not. Definitely not. I cornered myself. I punished myself every single time when I lost an opportunity. I've made mistakes. I've made blunders. I've made a fool out of myself. I've had heartbreaks. I've lost friends. I've been broke n number of times. But that doesn't stop me at all. Because in this entire journey of 12 or 13 years, I've had a few realizations, which I want to share. Number one, define your own success. Don't let anybody else define who you are and how successful you are. Number two, if I can't do anything, that's only because of two reasons. Number one, agalla, I can't do. Madalla, I won't do. Nothing else beyond it. Number three, I am replaceable. The minute I die, the world will move on. So stay grounded. Number four, it's not about winning or losing. It's about the fight in between. As I said, in the path towards success, we actually secretly enjoy the pain that we go through. That's what we actually crave for. Number five, you need not be smart or intelligent to lead a happy life. You can be comfortable and happy with what you are, provided you realize it. And number six, be your own guru. Hashtag lead your own life. Don't benchmark yourself with others because you don't know the kind of problems or troubles that they are in. It just looks nice on the upper crest. And finally, last but not least, nobody is spared. Aapka number aayega. I'm sure your number will come. So these are the few realizations that I've had. And one thing that I want to say is that every morning when I go out, I have this intense faith in myself that turns out into confidence. So if someone is asking me, Vinayak, how did you get past so many hurdles in your life? I would say only one thing, faith. Faith is the fuel for success. It is important to have faith in oneself. When I say this, including Lord Sri Krishna, quotes the same. From Sri Krishna till my mother, they all quote the same. Believe in yourself. In Bhagavad Gita's 6th chapter, it says, Lord Sri Krishna says, Uddharet Atmanatmanam, Atmanam Avasadayet. Atmaiva Hyatmano Bandhu, Atmaiva Ripuratmanaha. If I have to give a translation of this precisely or briefly, for your soul, for oneself, you are your own guru. You are your own friend. You are your own bandhu, relative. If you don't realize this, if you fail to understand this, you are your first enemy. The ability to pick oneself up in a situation is the only one who can stand up tall and high and walk with pride every single time when you're put into test. So all I want to say is, this is my journey and this is my understanding about success and failure. And what I wanted to share at the end of the day is, let the fear of success or failure not stop you from doing what you want. To be precise, guys, go out, make mistakes, be stupid. Life is the best teacher, and be your own master. Yours faithfully, Vinayak Joshi. Thank you so much.